This is Duke University.
It seems like society as a whole, and we can really say this concretely because Obama says it all the time, that you need to pursue a higher level of education. College is your goal. Reach for the stars. When you're encouraging a whole society to reach for the stars, not everybody can get to the stars. Not everybody can study and get to college, or let alone community college. So that leaves a lot of people at the bottom pretty discontent. And who picks the tomatoes, and who works at Subway? Who's gonna work there if everybody's discontent? We can't all have an elite education, right? So, if it's saturated, what happens to the people at the bottom?
You're terrific, because you asked a question in a form that you really didn't want to ask the question. You just said what you think. Now, what you think happens to be flawed, so I'm happy to tell you why what you think is flawed. It sounded plausible, it sounded like a real question, but it really isn't a question. You figured out a system. I say with great affection to you, so let me try to explain to you why, because what you said is commonly believed. You've just said something in the semi-form of a question that's commonly held. It sounds familiar to a lot of us. We have heard this kind of thing before. But there's something, and I don't know what President Obama has to do with it, but I avoid quoting presidents, no matter where, what political party they come from. So let's take the proposition about the distribution of population. So let's assume that there's a bell-shaped curve, right? There's a distribution of population, and that we are talking about what we're measuring it is educational attainment, right? Your proposition is not everybody is a rocket scientist. Not everybody in that. There's going to be some distribution of academic ability and achievement no matter what we do. What? Correct. The real question is, where does the bell-shaped curve rest? On what scale of educational attainment? You follow me? So the proposition of educational intervention is to move the entire scale upwards so that the minimum standard is adequate for productive work. You follow what I'm saying? And that is not turning everybody into a rocket scientist. It's actually lifting the bottom and the top, the whole distribution. So if the scale is, now the scale is here, my idea is that the government is responsible for shifting the entire population upwards. So if the minimum wage today is 1, in educational terms, right, the minimum wage will be 10. So, and I believe there's an immense elasticity in the distribution of educational attainment. So in answer to your question, educational intervention requires lifting the minimum and the distribution, the range of distribution. Therefore, but that doesn't answer your very good question of, do we have a society that provides people meaningful work where they're not discontent, right? Let's leave out the issue of unemployment, which we may be facing structural unemployment. Now, I can say, as a privileged citizen, I don't mind paying taxes to support a certain population that can't work. I don't think that's bad. I don't moralize about them. I think it's my obligation to tithe myself through my citizenship to support the people who are unable to work. But there's another, which you put your finger on, is a person who is an agricultural worker, picker. We have we run a school district in the Central Valley of California in Delano, together with a agricultural company called Paramount Farms. Mexican Americans, and we have a school there and a teacher training program. Because the University of California wouldn't do it. So the company approached us whether we would do it. We said yes. Now, those people who work there dream about their children's social mobility. That's what motivates them to pick, right? Now the question is, what work do we have, and do we value it for the people who, whatever, will not compete for the high-end jobs? And that's a very interesting question. We have to rethink how we value work and regard it. So service work, so-called menial work. Why do you think there's so much immigrant labor in the United States that's illegal? Because there's some people have now internalized a sense of entitlement and dignity, legitimately so, that there are things they won't do. And they won't do not only because it's not paid well, but because they won't do it because that's not what their expectations to be in a different social class. We have to address that constructively, not critically. And that's a very bedeviling problem. I'm always worried when I see an easy pass replacing a toll taker. There's a lot of mechanization and improvement which is not socially useful. I think elevator operators would be a great idea. Why do I need an automatic elevator? It would be much more pleasant to have to say, what floor, please? And we have a lot of employment for a lot of people. You follow me? We have robots make everything. Maybe that's good, but what are we going to do with all the people who are displaced by all the mechanization and robotics that's on the horizon? Your point's very well taken. And can we provide dignity to people who are elevator operators, doormen, toll takers? You know, we need actually to make people valued and useful in society, and not everybody is going to be a software engineer. But that doesn't mean that the level of education can't be improved so that they actually can live their life with a sense of quality and also participate in the democratic process at a very high level of resolution, or sufficient level of resolution.
Produced by Duke University.